Hey, good morning. Welcome back to Creator on Wheels. I'm Shiv and hope you guys are doing happy and healthy. Back again on a very cloudy, gloomy, cold Monday morning. It's 30th of August 2021 today. It's a festival day. I think it's kind of become a ritual that I'm going out like only once in a month, and probably the day when it's like a holiday for some XYZ reason. Weekend rides have become quite literally inexistent. I've hardly taken out my bike in the last 1 month. I think that's kind of my standard intro in the last 3-4 videos, I guess. Anyways, I think, yeah, it's true. Like, the last I went out was, I think about a month ago, at the end of July. Been a very hectic time on the office front and also on the personal front. Things are keeping me very busy, which is making me stay away from my Dusky and Mintu. Just went out for one nice short vacation with the family to Mysore. Just a few weeks back, but it was just a 3-day kind of a thing. But plan for today, I'm not sure. I thought like, let me take out the bike and plan later. Right now, as you can see, I am on the super famous Bidadi, the place which is home for, one of the places which is home for the famous Tata Idli. So heading on the Mysore road, towards Mysore rather, not really going till Mysore again. But we'll drive for a couple of hours and then see what I need to do, where I need to stop for breakfast or where I need to stop for lunch. Nothing really on the agenda. Let's see how things goes. And the traffic is way beyond what I expected. I know this road is not in a good shape, but it's undergoing all those 6-lane conversion. But on a Monday morning, heading towards Mysore, I didn't expect so much of traffic. In fact, like, I wanted to hit Mysore road and wear my gloves, but never got a chance to stop at all. It's really that bad. Okay, it looks like the sun god has come out. It might become a little bit warm, which is good because it's been cold in the last 45 minutes that I've been riding. Talking about riding without gloves, one thing that I wanted to bring up, probably I'll use this opportunity for a very quick or a short review. Something I recently changed is this grip covers. This is not the one which I had before. I changed it about 15 days back, if I'm right. And this is probably the first kind of like outside the city or a longer ride. But I just rode my bike a couple of times within the city, and outright I would say this is one of the best decisions that I have made in the recent past. I know I've not been riding the bike much, but I also know how annoying it is when it comes to the vibrations and not having a good grip on your handlebar when you're riding the bike. So these grips, or rather grip covers, are by company called Motorcycle Supply. I will link them in the description below. No, it will not be an affiliate link. I don't have any affiliation with them. I bought it with my own money. This is not a paid review or anything, so please be advised against that. So it cost about 400 rupees, I think 399 to be precise. I booked it on their website and I think it reached me within a week. But I never got time to change it. Though on the instruction leaflet within the packet, it says it's a 2-minute installation. I think you can beat that by putting this within a minute. It's literally that easy. They say that you need to dip the grip covers in soap water and slide it. I just took that one extra step wherein I kind of applied a drop of shampoo on the edge of the grips or the edge of the handle, and I think it just like went in within like 2 to 3 seconds, so it's really as easy as that. But the comfort is really a top notch. Yeah, so this kind of a grip cover I wanted to change from a very long time, and if I'm right, this is my third grip cover. Initially when I took the bike about 2 years back, I had something like that wrap thing, the leather wrap stuff that I was using. I had it for, I don't know how long I had it, I think for a few months. But I somehow felt that overlap that the wrapping kind of a grip cover gives. It was not very comfortable, irrespective of whether I'm riding without gloves or with gloves, it was not really that comfortable. So I removed that. I think I changed it when I was changing my first handle, so I just completely removed it. Once that was changed, the second grip cover that I had was the rubber one, the very ordinary one that you get in any of the motor stores. But that particular one was branded as acupressure kind of grip cover. A couple of my other friends had also already bought it. I think that costed about 115 or 120 rupees, if I'm right. It was good. I would not say that it was not worth it, but for the price you pay, it was worth it for like about a year. And as all of you know, the grip covers, especially the rubber ones, they tend to become hard over a period of time when they're exposed to water, sunlight, heat and all those things. So I started feeling that it is becoming hard, and it was becoming a little bit difficult, especially when I'm riding bare hands, like what I'm doing now. Not that I do it very frequently, but it was very evident that it was becoming hard. So that whole effect of acupressure thing was gone in that. So I think its life is about 1 year, and for whatever time I had it, it did its job. So I removed it myself. I took a knife, cut it off, and I put this one up. Before picking up this one, there was one another similar one which I had in my mind, but somehow the cost was not very convincing. That company is called Grip Puppies. Exactly similar grip covers, I think foam grip covers you can call it. I'm not sure if it is slightly thicker or a better material. I've not actually touched and felt that, but that's almost like 4 or 5 times the cost of this particular one. So this, as I told you, cost about 400 rupees. That was somewhere around 1500 rupees or slightly more. So I was not really convinced about spending 1600 on a grip cover. Maybe if I had that kind of a bike wherein it's okay for me to spend so much, it is okay. But I was not convinced. But I kind of like accidentally bumped into this one on Instagram, and I booked it immediately. And my first impression is that it's fantastic. It's really, really fantastic. It's worth that 400 rupees that you pay. It's kind of waterproof because I used it within the city, I think a week ago. It was raining, and I kind of rode my bike for almost 45 minutes or an hour in rain. And once I parked it in my house, within a few minutes it was all dry. It was not like a sponge wherein you squeeze the handle and it starts dripping water. No, it was definitely not as terrible as that. But very comfortable. They do say that this kind of a grip covers, when you use it, helps in suppressing the handlebar vibration up to a certain extent. I'm not telling that the Java is really as terrible as a Royal Enfield, at least the older Enfields, but the vibrations are there on a Java 42 or Java Classic for that matter. I can notice the change, the suppression is evident, but it is not that it is completely removed. So in that way, it definitely helps. It makes it very comfortable to ride. It's not too thick, it's not too thin. How long will it last? Time will tell. Probably let's check after like 3 months or 6 months and see if it still survives or it starts breaking apart or anything. But for now, I would definitely say that a good product, very comfortable, both that for 400 rupees that you pay, and definitely something you can try out on your bike, any bike for that matter. I'm not telling it only for Java, but any bike. In fact, like, I plan to use it on my Activa as well in the coming weeks. Just that not getting free time to do online shopping, so I'll definitely do that. So that's about a quick kind of like a 5 minute, I don't know how long I took also, so a quick review about these sponge grip covers from, I think I told their name right. Thank you so much, and I'll catch you guys again in the next one. Bye bye. Matte sigana.
One eternity later.
A quick update on the grip cover situation. Since I last spoke, I have been riding for almost like 75 kilometers now, non-stop on the kind of like a busy highway. Not really changing the gears so much, but it's been a stretch of about 70 to 75 kilometers. So far, the grip covers have been holding up really good. I would not really say that it removes the vibration completely, but it reduces noticeably. That's what I would say. But overall, the comfort level, everything is top notch, so highly recommended. Go for it.